God, it's The Rock!
The Rock!
The Rock! The Rock and Sock!
Oh, no!
Here comes Socko!
Oh, you gotta be kidding me! It's Mr. Socko!
The Rock and Sock Connection are walking tall here tonight! And by God, they're on their way to WrestleMania!
What does it mean to reform the Rock and Sock Connection on the biggest stage of all, WrestleMania, Madison Square Garden, WrestleMania 20? It means everything to me. And for me to come back to WrestleMania and team with a guy who I admire, who I respect, who gave his body for me, put his life on the line every time, it's a thrill, it's a pleasure. And I look forward to going to, of all places, Madison Square Garden, man, right there in New York City.
That's the challenge to me, is to recapture that Rock and Sock magic, but also put a match across at WrestleMania that's going to stand the test of time. The challenge here is to entertain people, but also produce one of those career moments, because we certainly have the vehicle to do it. WrestleMania 20 is as big as it possibly gets, and it's up to us to be up to the challenge.
The people want Mankind as The Rock's partner.
Can I share a secret with you? Me and Rock are going to be functioning as a team. You know why? Because there is a bond between the two of us that is inexplicable.
I want to be known from here on in as one half of the greatest tag team, The Rock and Sock Connection.
I think the importance of the Rock and Sock Connection at that time of its initial run was something that I know, honestly, I never really anticipated. I didn't anticipate the entertainment value, because I wasn't quite sure, because I had had these amazing matches with Mick Foley, where he would literally put his body on the line every time.
What the hell is Mick Foley doing? He's coming for more!
And then to go from that to the Rock and Sock Connection, and at first I was like, I don't know, Rock and Sock, it's got a cool name, but I don't know, I had to be shown it.
What is this? The Rock? What? You're kidding! It's the most electrifying... No! A double people elbow!
And within a week, not only was I made aware quickly of how good the team could be, but I was very impressed with everything.
We together are one luxury automobile. Rock is the front end, Mankind is the rear end, but not just any rear end, Lillian. Mankind is the people's rear end.
This is the beginning.
And I thought a partnership with Mankind would kind of soften them up a little bit.
In case you're wondering, you sicko, things between me and The Rock are strictly platonic.
All I'm saying is I want us to be kind of like the Three Musketeers. All for one, and by golly, one for all!
And it just worked beyond our greatest expectation, you know, the chemistry when we were in there together.
You smell! What the sock?
When I came walking down the aisle and, began ripping off The Rock's catchphrases one after another and kind of putting a Mankind twist to them.
Know your role! Hey, you kid, shut your mouth! And the dozens of Mankind's bands.
How do you feel?
It doesn't matter how I feel, Michael Cole. Lay the smack down.
Whoa.
Don't you ever, and The Rock means ever, steal The Rock's phrases again.
High five.
The fans just reacted, and it was a case where you were kind of giving them what they wanted without them knowing they'd even wanted it to begin with. It was great.
If you smack.
What did The Rock just tell you?
Oh man, there were so many Rock and Sock moments that I just loved. But there's this one particular moment where I was on the cell phone and Mick Foley had to come and tell me, like, Rock and Sock is ending and he's got to break up the team. So I was on my cell phone.
I'm gonna come right out and say it.
Sure.
I think we should just call it quits.
Absolutely.
He didn't know that I was on my cell phone because I had one of those little cell phones and I had it up to my ear like this and I'm just kind of there listening to the person who I was talking to.
It's just that there's so many other kids who need my help, who need my guidance, and you're almost there.
Right. Well, The Rock feels that way as well, too.
Yeah. No, I feel the exact same way. Sure. Yeah. All the while I'm talking on my cell phone. And then he's like, well, you know, and take care, kid, and I think you might be okay.
You're going to be somebody. Hold on one second. Who are you talking to?
Hey, don't get excited. I'm just here to say that you're going to be all right, kid.
And then I hang up, and then after that, throughout the show, Mick Foley goes to Stevie Richards. I think he's like, man, The Rock just didn't take it well. And that was a funny moment.
This is Big Rock. This is important. As a matter of fact, this is your life.
Another funny moment was, of course, the very first This Is Your Life. And I gotta give it up for Mick Foley, man. He's really a creative genius. He came up with this idea. He wanted to do a This Is Your Life. And I had never seen This Is Your Life to begin with, so I didn't know what it was all about until we actually did it. And we had so much fun doing that.
Rock, let me ask you this. Does mankind know how to throw a little Pardookie or what?
He proceeds to bring out my high school teacher, my football coach, and my old girlfriend.
The Rock just has one thing to say to you. Your ass on out of here.
You know, Rock, every day I get a little prouder and a little prouder to be your partner.
The Rock thanks you for that.
There was a great respect there, but there was also the acknowledgement of the fact that we were polar opposites in just about every way. I mean, just not in only appearance, but in personality as well.
Rock, what do you think of the new shirt?
What does The Rock think of your new shirt? Well, The Rock likes your new shirt. Looks great on you. Better yet, do you like your new shirt?
I like it.
It doesn't matter if you like your shirt.
The last time I fall for that one, Rock. You're not getting me again. I gotta steal that one sometime. That's good.
And that's what made it work to me, you know, it's like a real life odd couple.
I think the importance to the business was that here you had two guys who worked their asses off, just like all the other guys on the roster, but yet at the same time who really wanted to personify what sports entertainment was all about, of going out there and literally entertaining the fans every single night for 20 minutes, 30 minutes of whether it was talking on the microphone or physicality.
And The Rock means 20 minutes!
Don't you ever do that again, jabroni.
At that time, like, you really don't understand, or at least I didn't, the importance of what it served to the business, our business, of sports entertainment, until you look back and go, damn, we did some good-ass
Rock can suck. Rock and suck.